Yes, this bike does make you faster, but surprisingly, that's one of the least impressive things about it.
So today we're gonna take the new Santa Cruz Skitch on a proper gravel mission to see what works, what I'd change, and who I think this rig is for. So what are we working with? This is a 2023 Skitch carbon e-gravel bike from Santa Cruz. This one is set up with a flat bar configuration with a one-up mechanical dropper. It's a one-by in the front and an Eagle 1050 cassette in the rear with SRAM GX transmission, shifting all those wonderful sprockets, rolling on alloy Easton ARC wheels, set up with Schwalbe G1s 700 by 45. The Zua Ride 60 motor is powered by a 430 watt hour battery, which offers three power modes and a max speed of 28 miles an hour. It's got a claimed range of 60 plus miles. We'll test that. It weighs in at an impressive 30 pounds, which for an e-bike is kind of remarkable. The last e-bike I rode weighed in at 80 pounds. Essentially, this is a Stigmata on steroids. The most exciting thing about this whole mission is that I've never done an e-bike ride with another e-bike. So we got riding companion Ron Lewis, two e-bikes, and the Holy Mountain to see what kind of adventure cocktail we can come up with. What could possibly go wrong? All right, we're starting this one off in analog mode. We both want to try these bikes with zero power to start to see how they actually ride. Analog climb.
It's okay, it feels like a bikepacking bike.
It's a little heavy, but totally doable.
Feels like my old steel adventure bike. Let's try low, let's see what happens.
Low zone. There it is, green means go. Ooh.
Oh wow, perfect timing for the first real hill.
Oh, this feels good. Yes, indeed. Yes, indeed. Even in low power mode, it gives you the right amount of boost. It's rather addictive, to be honest. I don't ever want to not be boosted on this thing, even though I can be. Ron's on a borrowed bike. It's one size too small. It's about 10 millimeters less tire than he's used to. Plus the handlebars are skinny and the sun is in his eyes and he didn't. Honestly, the flat bars are really fun. Nice touch. Well played.
Now for the real test. See how these things climb trails, single track, through the woods.
Are you still in zone one?
Still in zone one, yeah.
All right. If you feel my affection, one of the biggest, most impressive things about this bike that I know because of that bike is that the motor on this thing is silent. No one around you can tell that you're on a powered bike. And that is a really, really nice feature. When you ride that bike, it kind of buzzes a lot. Kind of telling everybody that it's boosted. It's like, you know what? Let me be boosted, but let me just keep that to myself. What do you think of the noise?
It feels a little self-conscious when I'm riding around other people.
But dude, when it's silent, it's on a need-to-know basis. We just dropped power to see how it feels, and it sucks. Honestly, it like zaps the fun right out of it. I can't believe it, but having that boost makes it more fun. Specifically on the climbs. But man, you're like, wow! E-bikes, where climbing is like descending. So one thing I feel like I should clarify is these are no throttle, which means it's a pedal assist. Everything you put in, you get back out at different varying levels of power. So you still do the ride, you just do it quicker. Okay, question for you. Would you eat this?
Did you pick up dog dew again with a bagel?
All right, we're going power mode two. Get that blue dream. Whoa! Yeah! Ooh, I like this. Dropper engaged. Stoked to have that thing on this. Woo! Wow! Damn, that was awesome. God, this is crazy how much different this is. Whoa. You're just zipping right up these things. Okay, I've been experimenting with shifting the power up and down for little hills and little descents. It makes it, It makes it much more engaging of an experience. Plus, you're optimizing for power because there is a battery on this thing and you've got to be a little conscious of your range. So conservation is your friend if you want that boost the whole way through. This is a cool feature. They have a little USB-C plug right there on the top tube. So if you wanna, you know, boost up your Bluetooth speaker.
If your Dave Matthews Band is kind of sogging under the weight of the ride, boost it in there and you can do the funky chicken all the way up the hill. What would you say?
Might have to boost it to 2 for this one. We are trucking along. But don't be fooled. Even though we have assistance, we're still earning this climb. It just depends on how much power you need or want to use and how much you want to physically put into it. I mean, we both personally, we kind of like a little bit of the suffer. It keeps you honest. This stuff is exactly why we want this power. Kind of a grinder, pretty bumpy, just smoothing out those edges, pushing our way to the top.
Way smoother over there.
You're the one I need. Okay, kind of bumpy, coming through here. Oh boy. Okay, we're good. This stuff is bumpy as hell. What kind of gravel is this?
Terrible.
Like the Stigmata, this bike comes in only one color. I like to call it Goblin Green. What do you call it? Hey, Rome, what would you call this color?
Godzilla granular green.
Oh, yes, I'm indeed nervous to descend this. Whoa.
And shout out Santa Cruz for sponsoring this week's video and giving us the opportunity to talk about this crazy new rig and share those findings with you. But be warned, all opinions are my own.
It's basically the descending. The descending is just like a little trickier because it's a bigger machine, less movement, so which means it's harder to pick lines.
It's harder to pick lines, and there's less room for error because there's just more weight. There's just more pressure on the brakes, on your contact points, on your headset, everything. You can just feel the rattle, and you can feel the sort of, you can feel the bumps a lot more.
So I think the move is just power off for this descent because we know we're only going down. Conserve a little juice, because I would much rather have it on and up, personally. You can still toss this thing around though. It doesn't weigh too much. It's not in that 50 to 80 pound range where you're not getting any movement out of the back. And how you adjust the power levels, it's this little knob right there. You hit up, it goes up. One more. Pink, that's the fastest. You wanna slow it down, you just go down. White, that means off. That means analog. At this moment, I am appreciating the dropper and the transmission shifting. It's nice to know it's back there. In case this thing takes a little tumble, it's gonna be okay. And I have a massive range of gears to work with. That shifts so well under load. It's insane. These bikes don't weigh any more than like a Surly Cross Check or a Crust Evasion. So those bikes are gonna handle just as like sloggy, boggy, and loggy as these do, but these have this whole other crazy component to it.
It feels like a semi-loaded bikepacking bike. Like not the full pull, but like it feels like you got a loaded sack. I literally did not mean that.
That section was so awesome, and there were no watts abused during the shredding of that section. Holy crap, turning the boost back on feels amazing.
Yeah, it's nutty. Even after just doing all that single track, turning it on is just like, it's like hitting the showers.
It's like a free high. We're hauling. Another way I found to use these is that, especially if you have like a highway section, I'll just crank it up to full speed mode and just blast through it. There's no reason to savor the junky transport sections. That's another plus one for the power. You just use it when you need it. And man, is it fun to use. Look at Ron is loving it.
Oh God, it's getting worse.
And Ron, what kind of smileage are you getting out of that thing?
I'm getting a 10 out of 9.
Oh! Power level 2, making short work of this gradacious suffer section. It's technical in a very fun way, opposed to being technical in a very horrible way. The torque is so satisfying. It's just like getting you right on there, right up there. It's not necessarily speeding you up, it's just increasing what you're putting into it. It is such an interesting experience.
So what do you think so far?
I'm sold. It's not if, it's when.
And the only thing that makes an e-gravel mountain bike ride better is a big ass piece of pizza. Oh, and yes, we did eat that whole pizza.
We ate the whole thing. It was like the best thing the cafeteria at the high school had to offer.
How cool is that? And this used to be a road. This is what happens to a road when it doesn't listen to its parents. We're cooking. Oh, let the games begin. A lot of PSI in there. Just had a lactic acid moment. Give it a little bit of power boost and it kind of just wishes it all away. Highway, our way. Yeah. Floating up this stuff. Wow. That power helps you choose the line that you actually want to ride. Ay, ay, ay. Still a rigid ride. But that doesn't mean it's still not fun. Oh, it's just a different kind of fun. Oh. Get rad. Percent mission accomplished. What do I like about this bike? It's fun as hell. It's fast, it's quick, it does everything you want it to do. The only thing that I would change, if I could have my druthers and the stroke of some evil genie, I would make the battery last for up to 100 miles. That's it. And that just doesn't exist yet. That's like a future tech thing. So it's fine, you know, this is the best you get.
And the ride by the numbers?
4 hours even rolling time.
43 miles, yeah.
And 4,577 feet of elevation. And here's the interesting thing. There's still a third of a battery left. Color me impressed. What's your take on the e-bike?
I love it, I want one.
Do you need this bike?
I need one.
Well, you know, we like bikes. So the obvious answer is yes.
What it does, range-wise, is it puts me out into the stuff without having to chuff to the stuff.
I was also surprised at how seamlessly this thing integrates into the type of riding that we do.
It gets you out to the stuff with fresh legs.
Who do I think this bike is for? Anyone that wants a little assistance on some difficult climbs, someone who wants to minimize and speed up and ratify their commute, or if you're someone who rides with people that are just generally stronger than you. What do you think? How would you use this thing? These bikes very much serve a purpose. It's up to you to decide exactly how to integrate that into your purpose.
It's been a few days since that ride, and I've had some time to process. I think the Switch might actually be the best performance e-bike on the market right now. It's silent, the range,
the geo,
the weight, puts it in a category all its own. And this is coming from someone who owns the highest end e-gravel bike from Specialized. I would trade that Creo for that Switch in a heartbeat. Oh, and I almost forgot. I found your next gravel bike. It's right here. It's got everything you can imagine wanting, including a trunk. What will they think of next?